Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD.
Today I'm going to talk about hairy root culture. Hairy root culture, also called as transformed root culture, is produced after infection of explant by gram-negative soil bacterium, Agrobacterium rhizogenes. This process takes place advantage of a naturally occurring hairy root disease in dicotyledon. Hairy root cultures can be useful especially for the production of root-associated metabolites because of their high growth rate and genetic stability. Agrobacterium recognize the acetosirenzone signal molecule exuded from the wounded plant cell and become attached to it. The bacteria contain root-inducing plasmid called RI plasmid. The bacteria genetically transfer the part of RI plasmid called tDNA or transfer DNA to the plant genome where it is expressed. The tDNA region of RI plasmid is bounded with oligonucleotide of 25 base pair of genes that code for auxin production, cytokine production, and opine synthesis. Auxin is used for the elongation of cell to produce hairy root, whereas cytokines are used for cell division. Opine is a type of unusual amino acid like octopine, agropine, napoline, manopine, and cucumopine, which are used by bacterium as a source of carbon, nitrogen, and energy source. The RI plasmid consists of vir gene A, B, C, D, E, F, and G, where vir A recognize the plant metabolites and activate vir G gene, whereas vir G transcriptionally activator of other vir loci, and vir D nicks RI plasmid at tDNA border and covalently attached to T strand, whereas vir C involved in host range determination, where E act as a single-stranded DNA binding protein, where B transfer act as a transfer apparatus. Now this tDNA consists of left border and right border. Here the tDNA at the left transfer DNA consists of four genes, that is role A, B, C, and D. Although role A, B, C are involved in root induction, only role B is having the highest yield in root hair induction. Agrobacterium strains are of five types depending upon the type of opine produced. They are agropine, actopine, curcumopine, manopine, and napoline. Among these, agropine strains are the most commonly used strains as they have the strongest induction ability. Induction of hairy root culture in vitro. For that, first we have to wound the explant and then inoculate with Agrobacterium rhizogenes. Usually 2 to 3 days later, the explant can be transferred to the solid medium with antibiotics such as cefotoxin, vancomycin, or ampicillin to kill Agrobacterium rhizogenes. The hairy root will be induced within short period of time, which varies from 1 week to over a month depending on different species. The decontaminated hairy root can be subcultured on a phytohormone-free medium. After transformation, there are three types of markers to confirm transformation. One is morphological markers. Here we will see rapid growth and increase in branching and plagiotrophism. So these are the morphological markers. Coming to biochemical markers, since opine synthesis is encoded by tDNA of RI plasmid, opine serves as an effective biochemical marker. In case of genetic markers, tDNA localized in plant genome serves as a reliable genetic marker to confirm transformation. This is detected by Southern hybridization, DNA blot dotting to screen the presence of foreign gene sequence, detection of gene in genomic sequence by PCR. Next is growth characteristics of hairy root culture or transformed hairy root culture. In transformed hairy root culture, an exponential increase in biomass occurs as a result of lateral root formation and the consequent exponential increase in the number of elongating tip. Plagiotrophism of root in culture, product released into the growth medium, auxin sensitivity in hairy roots are seen. Now, how to increase the yield of secondary metabolites? The biosynthesis of secondary metabolites is strongly influenced by nutritional and environmental factors. Some of the physical factors are light, temperature, presence of chemicals including physical stress and applied magnetic field. The plant cells show ability to use a wide range of nitrogen source including urea, glutamate, casein and casein hydrolysate and amino acid mixture, but yet nitrate and ammonia are the two most preferred source of nitrogen in the growth medium for hairy root culture. The change in biomass yield as a direct effect of light, greening of root clones on exposure to the light, or an increased ability for shoot production on phytohormone free medium in response to light have also been reported. Even elicitors and heavy metals also enhance the secondary metabolites. There are few bioreactors which is used for the cultivation of transformed hairy root culture. They are spin filter bioreactor, stir tank bioreactor and turbine blade bioreactor, rotary drum reactor, bubble column bioreactor, airlift bioreactor or mist bioreactor are also used for the cultivation of transformed hairy root culture. Next, what are the advantages of hairy root cultures? The culture show fast growth which reduce the culture time and ease the handling. Hairy root system is genetically and biosynthetically stable. High production of secondary metabolites. The culture can grow under phytohormone free condition. Now, some of the metabolites produced through hairy root culture, they are morphine, which is used for medical purpose, and then chicorin, which is used as an antibacterial and anti-ulcer agent, quinine, it is used for curing malaria, berberin, an alkaloid with medicinal use for cholera and bacterial dysentery. Now, what are the applications of hairy root culture? Here, the culture can be used to regenerate a whole plant, production of secondary metabolite, expression of foreign protein, functional analysis of gene.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.